What's up, everybody out there in 420 land? This is the co-host of Two Stone Dudes Podcast, Ryan Castle. The Anchor app is where I got my start, and it's been amazing being a podcast host so far because of Anchor. Let me explain. It's the easiest way to make a podcast for free. That's right, it's free. Anchor then distributes your podcast to Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and so many more. And I won't forget about the creation tools that allow you to edit your podcast from your phone or your PC. And you can get paid with no minimum listenership. It's everything you need to make your very own podcast. Download the free app or go to anchor.fm. So this next segment is called Ryan's Random Thoughts. It is 5 o'clock in the morning on a Sunday, and I'm at work, and I'm listening to a JRE podcast, and it's between Joe and Rob Lowe. And they brought up something interesting that triggered me, which was to say that you can't make certain types of movies nowadays, and I don't get that. I don't get why other people's artistic creativity is hindered by the thoughts, feelings, and emotions of somebody else, or a small majority of people. Okay? This is what I gotta say about that. In no way, shape, or form is anybody's artistic creativity to be censored by anybody whatsoever. Because it's freedom of expression, it's freedom of speech. And this whole anti-American movement that I see by these snowflakes and these pussies and people who are weak-minded and just weak individuals altogether. You know what? If the apocalypse does happen, you're going to drop off anyway. You're not going to fucking make it. And if you're listening to this and you are one of those people, I can honestly tell you that I don't want you listening to my show. I'm pretty sure Rob would agree if he was here. We like strong-minded people. We like people who have opinions. We like people who aren't afraid to say or do certain things. You know, as long as it's not hurting anybody else, as long as you're not out robbing somebody, as long as you're not raping anybody, as long as you're not murdering anybody, as long as you're not bothering anybody else's existence, you should be able to do whatever the fuck you want to do. You know, as far, and I feel that way about the war on drugs. It's your body is a sovereign entity. You should be able to put whatever you want into it. You should be able to fuck up your own life as much as you possibly can without, as long as it doesn't bother anybody else. You know, you commit victimless crimes, you commit non-violent crimes. It's not bothering anybody. So, for somebody to say that they are offended by something like that, and that reaches the ears of people to the point where it stops production of something, that's not right, and that's common sense. You're being fucking rude to push your agenda on other people just because you don't like something. You're not the most important person in the world if nobody's ever told you. And if you are one of these people, I'm pretty sure nobody's ever punched you in the face or told you to shut the fuck up. And I think more of that needs to happen nowadays. Now, I don't want anybody to get physically harmed, but if it humbles you, maybe you need it. If nobody's ever told you that you're wrong or that your ideas are dumb, and you've just been led to believe that everything you say is right, and because people are afraid of hurting your poor little feelings, you need to get over yourself and stop taking yourself so goddamn seriously. Because life is too short to be taking things that seriously. You know, it's not society's job to protect you from fucking offensive things. Offensive things are going to happen. And it's ridiculous that people don't have the courage nowadays to stand up to a small portion of the population and say, you know what? You're fucking dumb. Shut the fuck up. Mind your own goddamn business if you don't like this. That's what needs to be said to people. And if nobody else is going to do it, God damn it, I'm going to do it. And this whole fear of being canceled, you know what, I run a fucking podcast, which is held on multiple platforms. I'm sure there's still more that are going to have, and I'm not that important. I don't even have that many listeners yet. But I'm pretty sure there's a good chunk of people that like to hear what I'm saying. Enough to where it's going to keep me on the air, keep me doing what I like to do, which is exercise my First Amendment rights. And I'll be damned if I let anybody stop me from doing that. Anyway, that's Ryan's Random Thoughts. Thanks for listening to this segment. I appreciate the support. By the way, speaking of support, there is a support button on the Anchor app or on anchor.fm. If you like the content, you like hearing what we're saying, and you'd like to support us, there's options to where you can give 99 cents a month, $4.99 a month, or $9.99 a month. Whatever you choose to give, number one, will be fucking awesome. Number two, it'll help me get some real equipment, because right now I'm operating off of two phones and a set of clip-on mics. I'd like to get some headphones, I'd like to get some real mics, and I could definitely use some help with my weed habit, which comes out to about $200 to $260 a month. So, oh, and what I could do is, if you run a small business or you know somebody with a small business, I will do a commercial. And even if you don't run a small business and you just like to get your name out there, I'll do a commercial like, this is for so-and-so who is sponsoring my content and this is what we know about him. And I'll tell people about you. Why the fuck not? Especially if you're a strong opinion. And that'll also hook you up as being an honorary guest on the show, and I'll do a small interview for you too. Anyway, that's the content that I'm putting out there for the next show, and I'm going to try to do more of these Ryan Random Thoughts. So thanks for listening, thank you for enjoying the segment, and keep on smoking, ladies and gentlemen. What's up, everybody out there in podcast land? This is your host of the Two Stone Dudes podcast, Ryan Castle, shilling away for the smoking realtor, Pete Castellucci. Are you looking to move to Arizona? Do you already live in Arizona, but you're ready to make a move to another neighborhood? The smoking realtor, Pete Castellucci, is the guy to call. You should get a hold of him at 623-208-3577. They call him the smoking realtor because upon purchase or sale of your home, Pete will bring over his barbecue that's attached to his pickup truck because it's that big. And he'll make enough food to feed you and any guest you decide to have over or anybody come to check out your home. Once again, that's 623-208-3577, and that's for the smoking realtor.
Hello, this is a previous guest named Danny Spina. I was part of the One Stone Cold Dude podcast with Ryan Castle. I wanted to thank Ryan Castle for everything he has done in the podcast community, also for the wrestling community, adding all types of local and other types of professional wrestlers other than the WWE as those out there in this world. Also, I love to thank all the underground artists and musicians that are still filling up today in Riverside, California, Phoenix, Arizona, and onwards. Thank you, Ryan, so much for having me on your podcast. I hope you have a great and enjoyable night. And always, everyone, please be supportive of the professional wrestlers that Ryan and his partner have on Two Stone Cold Dudes. Thank you. Two Stone Cold Dudes have to offer. Please always stay tuned for Ryan and his partner. They're tag teaming everything, everyone in their path. Thank you. Hello, this is Danny Spina. I was a previous guest for Ryan Castle on Stone Cold Dude. Sending out all my appreciations to Two Stone Cold Dudes. And I also wanted to tell you that please support and be very supportive.
The This is segment two of the Two Stone Dude podcast, bonus episode by Ryan Castle, the co-host. I want to put this out to anybody who is suffering from the disease of addiction. I unfortunately ran into an addict today who kept asking me for money and followed me around a parking lot as I was working, trying to help me clean up and asking me for money. And I had $5 on him, so I gave it to him. If you're suffering and you want to stop, there is help out there. There's a great program called Narcotics Anonymous. It is a 2-step program, which models AA, but they concentrate on the disease of addiction, not the symptoms that are included in it. Because if you get to the root, you can nip that shit in the ass and you can gain freedom from active addiction. NA.org is the website to check out if you'd like. Also, there's a gentleman on Facebook named Nick Devano, who will probably talk to you if you get a hold of him and say, hey, I heard this on Castle's podcast on Two Stone Dudes that you're a guy that can help me out, so can you just talk to me for a minute? And I'm pretty sure Nick will give you his time and attention. He's a good dude like that. But I just want to put it out there that there is help, that it's not a hopeless situation. And then if you really want to stop, you can. It just takes a small amount of effort on your part. And don't worry about being the rest of your life. Just concentrate on minute by minute, day by day. And take it one step at a time. That's all I have on 12-step programs. Thanks for listening to this segment. Welcome back to the next segment of the Two Stone Dudes podcast. This is your co-host, Ryan Castle. And I am with...
Rob the Nut.
Yeah! Rob is going to go on his little tangent of his thoughts of the day. Rob, take it away, guy.
Man, I smoke bud, right? Correct. Many people do. But sometimes my bud don't work. You know, I get the strongest shit on the planet, and it don't work for that moment. You know why? My rant of the day is talk about some of these so-called parents here in Arizona. I would have to say, I can't understand it. Just like people leaving their car, their children in the backseat. We got that out here, and we also got, you know, kids get drowned in their own pool. Now, it is a big thing, and you know what? It's actually Drowning Prevention Month. Yeah. Exactly. I didn't know it was so difficult to make sure your back door is locked, or your hinges are up, or everyone's communicating. You know what it is? It's communication. Lack of communication. Even a crackhead can communicate with another crackhead.
Where's that needle?
You know, but I'm saying, you can't communicate with other relatives like, hey, take turns watching, especially the young ones. It's crazy. Where's the little one at? I was raised by, if you don't hear nothing, something's happening. Now that everyone's all in technology, just stuck in their phones. Ooh, yeah, still smoking, by the way, so just trying to get my 20-minute kick. But yeah, it's ridiculous. Actually, this one was a gift. It was one of these little pen cartridges. He mentioned the flavor, but you know what? Who cares? We're middle-aged attractive men. We can just go by, we can take what we can get, especially with this week. Yeah, that's all I'm talking about is the marijuana. Yeah, everybody, I'm just it provides my brain that people just don't really pay attention to their little ones and then going through the COVID-19 business. And, yeah, it's on the news. It's about good morning, good day, good, we have some stories to bring up. And, yeah, I don't want to hear a story about your mom when you're already basically staying at home already. How can you miss your kid? I had three locks on. I'm saying even living here in Arizona for the past 10 years, my son is 5. He was the youngest out of my 2 stepbrothers, and he would rent them out if they go by the door. He knew better.
Same one I see on my phone every day.
Slow the testing down.
I love that.
You do a great impression of him, too.
Maybe. I don't know. I'm too high to know.
Oh, shit. I'm kind of high off of no sleep right now. I've been up since 2 a.m. That's where I was able to get those random thoughts on the couple segments ahead.
Ryan is a workaholic on the weekends, just so you guys know.
Yeah. It's overtime at 18-something an hour. And it's worth it. It's worth it. I miss some of my weekends, but even if I miss my weekends, fuck it. You still come over and hang out with me, and we have a good time just bullshitting on this podcast. And that's important.
Over a cup of Joe.
Yep. Or some water.
Water. Yes, in Arizona, water is very essential.
It's ridiculous. I go through, Rob's looking at 2 gallons right now, and I've gone through both of these in the course of from 2 a.m. till about an hour ago. I've just refilled a 3rd gallon of water.
Woo.
I have kidney damage, my right kidney, from an OD, so I have to drink water.
Just got to drink that water.
So,
I've seen people drink coffee, ride a bicycle, have a cigarette out here.
Give a shout out to Danny. Danny's the only one that responded to our text messages.
Yes, Danny.
You showed your support. We had him on as a guest, and we appreciated the fact that he took his time and effort out. And that guy goes to work at like 10 o'clock at night, so he woke up specifically just to do that message for us.
I take a drag just for you. And we got 1 slip of the water just in your name.
And Danny is a beer drinker. He likes hard apple cider. So I think as a gift for him doing that, Ooh. We're going to get him a 6-pack of Red's hard apple cider. I think yeah. That'd be a good parting gift.
That's not bad.
I want to talk about the support button that's on the Anchor app. We're trying to get equipment, some real cool equipment, some mics and some headphones. And we're also willing to do commercials for anybody who has a small business and wants to help us monetize. Now, there are 3 options. One is 99 cents a month, $4.99 a month, or $9.99 a month. And the more you contribute, the longer of a commercial, even if you don't have a business, we'll just talk about you for 10 minutes if you monetize us.
Yeah.
I think it's a good idea. What do you think, Rob?
I got no problems with that. Everyone's got something to say, and many want to be heard.
Right. Let's give a shout out real quick to the Smokin' Realtor who we ran commercials for. He is going to give us $250 a pop for every home that is sold and has a connection to our guest.
Get those people homes. Get them living.
Right. So if you are thinking about moving to Arizona, call Pete Castellucci. The number is going to be on one of the segments. Or if you're just trying to move into another neighborhood, Pete is the guy to call. Now, why, you ask? It's because the Smokin' Realtor moniker is he will make food for you upon purchase of a home or while you're selling your home and you have guests coming on. He takes his grill that is so big, he has to attach it to his pickup truck in order to move it around. And he'll make steaks, chicken, ribs, whatever you can think of, and he'll help you out if you have too much clutter around the house. He'll load that shit in the back of his pickup and take it to the dump for you. All service is rendered there, huh, Rob?
It got me thinking real hard on it now.
Tell me, you're trying to get a decent sized place because you got your kid coming with you soon, and
oh yes, plans are in movement.
And with that being said, Rob, it's about time to go swimming, isn't it?
Yes, we could jump in the pool and make sure I don't get my pen wet. the One, I'm smoking. Everything else, feel free to splash, splash. Yeah, get stoned a little bit and be on our merry day.
Yep, everybody out there, be safe around water. Watch your kids. And put a smile on Rob's face, letting him know you're...
Yeah. Ass whippings are fine, but don't let your kids drown.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for listening to this segment of the Two Stone Dudes podcast. This is your co-host, Ryan Castle, with...
Rob Denat.
Yeah! Enjoy the rest of your weekend, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm hoping you had a great weekend. Thank you for listening to this little bonus episode. Want to keep it nice and fresh for you. And this next week should be all hooked up. I'm not going to advertise any guests right now. I will do that. I'll do that tomorrow. You guys know who's going to be on according to the schedule that I've announced before. And you know, I'll just let it out. Let me check the calendar real quick because I'm kind of stoned right now. I really don't remember. So let me just check my calendar. Give me 2 seconds here. So tomorrow, on Monday, we are going to have Wade Garrett on, who is a gentleman from my hometown who's really outspoken and has a ton of great opinions on a bunch, and it should be a good time. So tune in tomorrow. It'll be 5 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. Thank you for listening once again, and enjoy what's left of your weekend. My mouth is pure cotton like a t-shirt's coffin.